Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I got a donation of 4 vintage PCs who used to belong to a recently deceased guy who actually used to work with the computers I'm currently writing a book about. A friend of his decided to donate the machines to me. However, the same friend also decided to remove the hard drives in order to protect the privacy of his friend, which I of course condone. The problem is that I really need to look at his work data. That's kind of the interesting thing about these machines. So I asked the friend nicely if I promised to delete anything that resembled private data, could I please have the hard drives as well? And the friend said yeah. So now I got a bunch of hard drives and a bunch of computers, and I need to figure out what goes together. That is what this video is all about. This video will also be a small walk down memory lane through 4 generations of vintage PCs. Well, vintage. Somehow vintage. But before we get started with that, would you please do me the huge favor of subscribing to my channel? That would make me very happy. That tells YouTube that you like my content, and YouTube will then show my content to more people. If you already subscribed, then consider sending this video to a friend or two who also likes old computers. That would make me so happy. Thank you very much. And while you do that, I will run the intro. Yeah! Okay, so I got 4 computers right here. So, I think this is most likely the oldest one. I guess this is the next, and then this one, and then this one. Have some drives. This is a 160 terabyte Barracuda Seagate. This is a 10 gigabyte IBM drive. Then we got a Maxter drive right here. This is a Maxter. I can't see the size. No idea about the size on that one. So far, all IDE drives. This is another Seagate drive. This is a 250 gigabyte drive, still IDE. Another IDE drive with no size on it. Oh, it's a 60 gigabyte Samsung drive. 160 gigabyte. And another 160. But this one has a label on it that says it was removed in 2007. So this is most likely a spare drive he had. Or maybe an old backup drive. And this is a 40 gigabyte drive as well. Okay, how to proceed? I think I'll try to see if I can boot the oldest one first. Okay, I hooked up the first machine, or the earliest machine. Took some time finding a keyboard that would work with it. And also the power supply had come undone. I think the guy who took it apart took out the power supply to take the drives out, but I think I'm ready to boot it up now, so let's see what this contains. Okay, so this seems to be an AMD K6 266 megahertz with 128 megabytes of memory. Let's go into the BIOS. Maybe we got a hint in here to see what hard drives it you... Ah, crap. Okay, so... I didn't get any smarter of that. So, so this is an IDE cable. And this is a single IDE cable. So, let's see what we have. So that's a 10 and that's a 60 gigabyte hard drive. I think I will try to hook up the 10 gigabyte drive first to see if that maybe be Oh, that's jumpers on that one. This one is jump to master. So that could very well be a boot drive. Yes, it is balancing. Let's try again and see what happens. Auto detect. Let's see what you get. Okay, so the secondary master found a drive. Let's see if we can boot on that. The floppy disk is failing. Well, it's not connected, so that makes sense. Ooh, Windows 98. I kinda need a mouse, I think, now. Let me just find a mouse. I found a mouse. Okay, after looking around at this hard drive, I concluded that it's a Windows 98 drive, and it looks like he used it to do his taxes on from 1997 until 2007. So I'm gonna write a post-it note that says Windows 98, 97 until 07. Yeah, and I know he might have transferred the files and stuff, but that's my best bet for now. But besides from that, there don't seem to be any interesting stuff on this machine. So, on this hard drive, of course. So, I'll shut it down and move on to the next. This is a little bit bigger, so that might be his data drive. It will not detect this drive. I just tried it as a slave drive to the other one I found, which was working. Just check what this jumper says. So it's set to cable select. Just try to change it to master. Okay, this drive seems to be dead. Or at least it's not functioning in this machine. And I think that this machine is the best candidate for a 60 gigabyte hard drive. Let's just so I'll just write a note for this one, says undetected in K6 system. What else do we have? This Maxtor drive seems pretty old as well, and that might have been in this machine because it has these brackets, and it could have been in this space that would require him to take out the power supply. So let's just boot this up and see if there's anything interesting on it. No, there's not. I don't know if you can hear it. This drive is bad. But it just detected. Okay, don't try this at home, kids. Don't try this at home. Sometimes that kicks them. Into live, and actually that seemed to work. Let's see if it starts up. No, it starts making those sounds again. I remember those Macs that drives, they just like died for a hobby. It's a 3 gigabytes. Oh. Probably sold as a 4 gigabytes. Funny sounds. Okay, what else? 160? I don't think this machine will read 160. However, this is 160 and this one says 2007, which was the time this machine was last used, at least with that hard drive. So that's a 40 gigabyte. That might be interesting to test out on this machine. 160 gigabytes. And so I think I'm going to put these four sides. This is large hard drives. I will test them out in the larger machine, but first I will give this one a quick spin in this machine. Ooh, this got a nice rubber thing on it. It's pretty clear to me that the drive I just found was his primary boot drive, and somewhere there must be a data drive as well. I hope this might be the one. I'm not sure. Let's have a look. I didn't check the jumper settings. It appears it's set to master and it's not showing up. So this might be a dead drive. Okay. So I got 4 drives here, and only one of them was clearly working. I'm gonna put this aside. And even though this is a super nice machine, I think I'll be moving on to the next one now. Okay, I just upgraded to a USB mouse and a USB keyboard and installed the newer machine here. This machine had a sticker on top who said Windows Millennium with the license key. But in the front, it has one who says Microsoft Windows 2000. It also has one who says AMD Duron and one who says Sound Blaster. So let's start this up and see what happens. This is an ATX, so I need to turn it and power it up over there first. So and this list seems to be 400 megabytes of memory. Let's see what the setup says. If hardware monitor, okay, so there was no, I hope there was a list of hardware, but this is apparently too new for that. Well, let's drop in a hard drive and see what happens. So this is the smallest of the larger ones. I'm going to try. This is 160 and 260s. I'm just gonna pop in one of them and see what happens. It's a 900 megahertz. AMD Duron. Let's also detect the hard drive. Yes, it found 160 gigabyte hard drive, and it also found the two CD-ROM drives. There's a 52 speed burner in here. No, what? There are two burners, one 52 speed and one 48 speed. I guess this guy did some pirating, maybe, huh? I have no idea why else you would want two burners. Well, maybe one of them broke and could only read, and he just kept it for a read. I don't know. Okay, show me some booting. Come on. Something. I got a cursor. The fan in this one does not sound in a very good condition. So, I'm not getting it. I don't think we'll get anywhere. Well, Windows Millennium booted really, really fast. Windows 2000 didn't boot that fast, but it wrote something on the screen while trying to boot, at least. So, but this one was detected. So this might be a data drive. Okay. So this one just booted too fast for me to enter the BIOS. I actually think this one is configured as a slave. Okay, this one shows up as a slave. I'm just gonna try to add the other one as a master. For some reason, it boots so fast that I can't get into BIOS. So, but this first one showed up as master, and the second one showed up as a slave. So, this should technically be able to work together. Let's see what happens. I see two hard drives. Oh! Ah, I think I know what is wrong with the keyboard. I think the BIOS doesn't have legacy USB support enabled. So I'm just gonna hook up a PS2 keyboard instead. Okay, it might be that this machine, maybe I paired the wrong drives with the wrong hardware. It won't boot in normal mode, but I just asked it to boot in failsafe mode. No, it ends up same place. Okay, maybe I can boot it into the command prompt, but I'm pretty sure this is a Windows 2000 set of hard drives because it boots into something that looks like the NT kernel. Okay, I'm pretty sure that I need to boot. Well, maybe those are not for this machine. Maybe it's just broken, the installation. But the drive seems to be working. So I think I'll try the other disks, and then if I get a working system up and running, I can install them again and see if there's anything on them. Otherwise, I have a computer which is dedicated for imaging old drives, and I can just use that one. But it would be funnier to see this one running. And this one, I guess this was 2K/NT. seems to work. No boot. I still have one. I have two machines, but I just figured out that the largest one, the newest one, has SATA drives in it. So it wasn't taken out yet. So there's a good chance that that might actually still work. But let me try this to 150. And see what happens if I try to boot on that one. Hey, starting Windows. Windows 2000 booting up. Interesting. This would seem like this machine has been used for network. It also seems that it didn't ask me for a password. Would also seem that the mice is not working. Okay. I don't want you to reconnect to a server which probably doesn't exist anymore. Maybe one of these machines has been used for a server. That might explain why he kept them all. And it seems like it booted. The mice is still not working. Just tried hooking up the PS2 mice. I know you shouldn't do that while it's turned on, but yeah, okay. So according to timestamps, this one has been used up until 2010. It would seem like we successfully identified more or less all the hard drives. I'm actually considering taking those that wouldn't be recognized in the other machine and check them on this one as well. So this was the one in the bag with some text written on it, which says 160 gigabyte as well. And I'm just trying to boot that up and see what happens. This appears to be the Millennium installation. So this might very well be the original hard drive for this machine. Remember, it had a sticker on top which said Windows Millennium. Let's give this a boot and see what happens. I can't believe I'm booting a Windows Millennium installation. Do you think anybody have done that for like the past 15 years? That system was a nightmare. However, Windows Millennium was the last, essentially it was the last version of DOS, because Windows 95 and Windows 98 and Windows Millennium was built on top of MS-DOS. And when Windows Millennium stopped and Windows 2000 took over, it was actually the Windows NT kernel who took over. I don't know if maybe there has been some minor releases of DOS for legacy purposes, I don't know. But that's not the point. Oh, now the USB mice works. I'm not sure about the USB keyboard yet. The caps lock doesn't work yet, however. It's slow. Really slow. Just booting. Yeah, I know. We should be very, very pleased for SSD drives these days. I mean, this just spinning and ticking around, and I haven't even started this system yet. It's still just, you know. Oh, now it's one drivers for my monitor. I don't have that. But we identified the Windows Millennium drive, so I'm gonna make a post note for that. Oh, and the clock just changed to summertime. It thinks we are in the 1st of March 1999. Well, that's as good a place as anywhere to be, I guess. I don't think I will be showing the monitor of this one. There seems to be quite a bit of private names, so you know what? I'm gonna cut this machine and celebrate that we got identified the well, the main content of this drive. And then this was the two drives that the other machine wouldn't identify, and I'm just putting him. So if the BIOS on this one won't recognize them either, I think it's a pretty safe bet they're dead. It spins up though. Oh, it actually detected them, and I wasn't fast enough to enter BIOS, but it's booting Windows 2000. And I'm gonna stop it because we're not going to spend any more time booting this machine. So this one actually works. So I'm gonna change this one to works in Duron. Boots Windows 2000. This was a drive with a nice rubber sleeve on. Let's see if that boots. It's detected. And it boots Windows Millennium. I'm gonna shut this one off right away because I don't need to see any more Windows Millennium stuff. So, works in Duron. Windows Millennium. I'm not gonna show you how I go through the content of these drives because even the desktop on them contains names. So I would spend way too much time editing out stuff that you were not allowed to see. So I think I will give the other two machines a spin now. Yeah, I checked all the hard drives, so I'm just going to power up the machine which is a number larger and see what kind of machine that is. And then the final one has its own drives inside it, so I will figure that out by itself. So let's get rid of this one. This machine says Pentium 4 on the front, and it says Windows XP, and I don't see a license key. The boot screen says Pentium 4, that's a good sign. And it also says insert system disk. I hope I could get into some kind of BIOS to maybe get some specs on the system. Yeah, there we go. It's a 2 GHz Pentium with 2 GB of memory. Yeah, well, pretty boring, but yeah, one for the collection, I guess. I'm not going to go anymore into that one. Maybe the drives that could not boot would work in this one. Because that might be Windows XP and that might refuse to boot on the older hardware, I'm not sure. I don't care, to be honest. I'm going to go to the big machine now, and actually I already donated these machines to somebody else. I really don't need any more old-ish PCs. I mean, they are too new to be interesting and too old to be useful, so somebody would like to play games on them. That's hopefully what they will be used for in the future. Okay, so this machine has a Windows 7 license key on it. And how do you... So I just disconnected. There are two SSDs and two hard drives in it. And I just... I disconnected the first SSD and the two last hard drives. The second SSD was not connected. So yeah. But I'm going to try to boot it and figure out what kind of hardware this is. That's a Intel Core i7, 3.2 gigahertz. And it will of course not boot into anything because... But let's see if I can get into a BIOS and see if there's anything interesting in there. Could be nice to know what generation it is. It's pretty dusty. So it might be Gen 2 or 3 maybe. No, it wasn't F2 or delete. Let's try F10. Oh, it's right there. It says delete. I was, maybe I just wasn't fast enough. There we go. So 8 gigabytes of memory in two sticks, so there are 2 4 gigabyte, but I don't see any specs on the CPU anywhere. Okay, let's hook up the hard drive and try to boot it. Oh, not the SSD, of course. I just connected everything as it was. Let's see what's happening. I just found the hard drive, so that's a good start. But it was too fast for me to read it. Starting Windows. So yeah, all of these installations are speaking Danish, so I. Yeah, just translate on the fly. But yeah. So currently we are booting Windows 7 Home Premium. Let's see, maybe he put a password on this one. I don't have a... Yeah, there's a USB stick you can use to zero out the password on a Windows NT based system. I don't have one of those ready, so if it's locked, we don't know. But I'd really much like to see the specs on the processor to see. Well, maybe this could end up like a secondary office PC here at the studio. We could use that. If it's too old for that, maybe I'll just give it to my dad so he can use it to play YouTube videos in his workshop. He asked for a computer to do that with last time I saw him. Yeah, 8 gigabytes of memory is enough to. Should be enough to play YouTube. It started. So the user interface has been dialed back to look like Windows 2000. I actually did that in a period as well, where when I ran Windows XP on some systems, because I just liked the simple plain look of Windows 2000. I thought Windows XP was way too bloated. Windows 10 is a little bit better, but I'm sure Windows 11 will be a nightmare as well. It's like Microsoft does, like every second operating system is a cluster, beep, and the other ones in between are decent. I still find it's slow. It's really slow. Just let me right click and say preferences, please. Oh, nice. This motherboard actually has an IDE connector, which means I can use this system for dumping the other hard drives. So I don't need to use my own dumping rig for that, which is nice because right now I am helping my cousin to recover her drive from her laptop because it broke down, and currently we have been doing that for 13 hours, but it seems to be working. So that machine is occupied right now, but I could use this as a secondary imaging machine. I don't know, I might just give it to my dad anyway. And you are not seeing the screen because it's full of personal things, I think. I'll show you the screen if I at some point can get something in full screen. There you go. It's not showing. Oh, it showed up there. So this is actually a generation 1 Core i7. That's yeah. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this walk down memory lane, watching like 4 generations of hardware. Maybe the testing of the drive wasn't that funny. I hope that when I'm done going through the hard drives, I will find some interesting that I maybe can tell you a little bit about. But for now, I cannot share anything because privacy is very important to me. Please don't ask what I found on this machine. If I find anything that I'm willing to share, I will do it by my own accord. If you consider donating anything to me, rest assured that I am not going to share any kind of personal information, because that's... I would never... No. I respect even dead people way too much to do that. Okay, as I said, I hope you enjoyed this walk down memory lane. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and send this video to some of your friends who like to play with old computers. And then I guess I see you out there in the dark corners of the interwebs.